ஆழ்வார் எம்பெருமானார் ஜியர் திருவடிகளே சரணம், ஜியர் திருவடிகளே சரணம். வி ரீசன்ட்லி செலிப்ரேட்டட் புரட்டாசி திருவோணம் ஸ்ரவணம், விச் இஸ் தி ஆஸ்பிஷியஸ் திருநக்ஷத்திரம் டே ஆஃப் திருவேங்கடமுடையான் ஸ்ரீனிவாசன் எம்பெருமான். என் திருமலா திருப்பதி கிராண்ட் பிரம்மோத்சவம் வாஸ் செலிப்ரேட்டட் டியூரிங் திஸ் டைம். This Puratasi Thiruvonam is also the Tirunakshatram day of a renowned Acharya of our Sampradayam, Vedanta Acharya, Vedanta Deshikar. Let us enjoy his life and glories a little bit now. He was born in Tirutanka, which is also known as Thuppul. This is a Dividesham in the great holy town of Kanchipuram. He was born as the son of Anantasuri. At the proper ages, he undergoes the proper sanskarams. Even at a very young age, he was a great intellectual. He was greatly blessed by Nadadur Ammal, who is a great scholar in Sri Bhashyam. Nadadur Ammal was the disciple of Engalalvan. Kidambi Appullar is the maternal uncle of Vedantacharyar, who was named Venkatanathan when he was born. He is also greatly glorified as the incarnation of the divine bell of Trivengadamudayan. Kidambi Appullar, who is the maternal uncle of Vedantacharyar, was the grandson of Kidambi Achan, a very dear disciple of Emperumanar. Kidambi Appullar was regularly attending the Kalakshepams, lectures of Nadadur Ammal. Venkatanatha, as a child, would accompany Kidambi Appullar to the Kalakshepam. It was at that time Nadadur Ammal greatly blessed this young child to become a great scholar in the future. After some time, after getting married and becoming a great scholar in Vedantam, Venkatanatha starts debating with scholars of various schools of thought and defeats them all. It is because of this reason he was given the great honorary title Kavitarkika Kesari by Sri Ranganachyar, Periya Piratiyar herself. She also honors him with the title Sarvatantra Swatantra. Periya Perumal, Sri Ranganatha, gives the title Vedantacharya to him. Vedanta Deshika and Vedantacharya are synonyms. Vedantacharya spends some time in Tiruvayindrapuram, a wonderful Dividesham. He meditates upon Hayagriva Emperuman, and he was blessed by Garuda himself. Garuda Alvar himself performs Mantrobadesham to Vedantacharya. He also visits many Divideshams and performs Mangala Shasanams to many of the Dividesha Emperumans. During the Islamic invasion, Mughal invasion of Sri Rangam, he was present right there, and he leaves Sri Rangam at that time and goes towards the western region and stays in Satyagalam for quite some time. His greatest contribution to our sampradayam and his most generous benediction to all of us is his granthams. He had written so many wonderful granthams, whether it is Siddhanta Sthapanam, that is establishing our philosophy, or it is the glorification of Embermans in Stotrams, or Rahasya Granthams, Vyakyanams. He was a master in all of these areas, and he had composed many granthams in all of these areas. He had written a detailed commentary explanation based on Gita Bhashyam of Embermanar, which is known as Tatparya Chandrikai. Many granthams such as Tattva Tika, Nyaya Siddhanjanam, Shatadushani, Adhikarana Saravali were all composed by Vedantacharya. His Paduka Sahasram is a wonderful compilation on Sri Shatari, Sri Shatakopam Nammalvar, who is considered as the Paduka of Emberman himself. His Rahasya Trayasaram is one of the most important Rahasya Granthams. Munivahana Bogam is a wonderful Tamil commentary for Amalanadipiran, Manipravalam commentary for Amalanadipiran. And he has written so many Stotra Granthams on many Embermans, Divideshya Embermans. Many of these granthams are studied under acharyas as kalakshepam even today. While we look into the life of Vedantacharya, we can see he was filled with jnanam, bhakti and vairagyam. His jnanam is revealed in many of his granthams, which establish the Siddhantam and our Sampradayam principles. His bhakti is revealed in many of the Stotra Granthams, where he outpours his emotional attachment towards many of the Divideshya Embermans. His vairagyam is seen in many granthams, such as Vairagya Panchakam, and also in his own life, where he led a very detached life in worldly possessions. We also see a wonderful relationship existing between Vedantacharya and many of the acharyas before his time and after his times. He had great respect for acharyas such as Pillai Lokacharya, who was very elderly to him, who was residing in Sri Rangam and leading the sampradayam from there. Vedantacharya composed Lokacharya Panchasat, glorifying Pilla Lokacharya. He also revealed in his Granthams that he greatly benefited by being surrendered to Acharyas in Sri Rangam. And he mentions that he had the great fortune to interact with such great Acharyas in his Granthams such as Abhidhi Stavam, Bhagavadhyana Sopanam and so on. Many Acharyas after Vedantacharya's time had great respect and reverence. Vadikesari Adigimanwadajiyar in his Tattva Deepam and other Granthams refers Vedantacharya's Granthams. Manavala Mamunigal, a great Acharya, in his commentaries for Mumukshupadi and Tattvathrayam, quotes the words of Vedantacharya and fondly refers to Vedantacharya as Abhyuktar. Abhyuktar means one who is most respected, most revered. Erumbiyappa, one of the main disciples of Manavala Mamunigal, in his Vilakshana Mokshadikari Nirnayam, refers to Vedantacharya's Nyasa Vimsati and provides the essence of that Grantham as well. Dodayacharya of Chodasimhapuram, a great Acharya of our Sampradayam, has written a beautiful commentary for Vedantacharya's Shatadushani. This commentary is known as Chandamarutam, and even today Dodayacharya family has the title Chandamarutam Dodayacharya. Prativadi Bhayankaram Anna, a well-known Acharya in our Sampradayam, was the recipient of the mercy and blessings of Vedantacharya initially, and eventually he becomes a disciple of Manavala Mamunigal. In this manner, there was mutual interaction, mutual reverence, respect and glorification of Acharyas. On this auspicious occasion, we recollected some glimpses of Vedantacharya's life and glories. Alvar Emberumanar, G.F. Thiruvadigale Sharanam, G.F. Thiruvadigale Sharanam.
To learn such valuable information about our Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya, please download Koyil, K-O-Y-I-L app from Google Play Store or Apple App Store. Our website is koyil.org, K-O-Y-I-L.org.